What is COVID? What are the symptoms of the disease? What does COVID mean for you as a diver? COVID is today very present in media. A lot of action is taken to prevent further spreading of the disease. But what does COVID mean for you as a diver? Today I want to explain you simple rules to prevent an infection and how to come back to diving after infection with COVID-19. Hello together. My name is Dr. Manuela Schoch. I'm an anaesthesiologist and specialist for intensive care medicine, and I'm living in Germany. The hospital I'm working at is a competence center for patients with COVID-19. And my daily work is related to respiration and respirators. I'm a physician for diving medicine and an active GOE diver. I'm as well an instructor and instructor trainer for DAN and GOE life support classes. But what is COVID? First, let me explain what the disease COVID exactly is and what it does. So COVID is an infection with the new coronavirus SARS-CoV-2. This virus attacks primarily the respiration system and the lung. And the main target are the lung cells. And as we know, there are more effects on other organs like the heart, the liver, the spleen, and the central nervous system, including the brain. The mechanisms are various and not completely understood yet. The main of those side effects is an inflammatory reaction of the body. It can cause direct damages like myocarditis, and this is an inflammation of the heart muscle. Other symptoms can be related to a higher probability to develop a thrombosis. This can happen in various locations in the body and occur of different severance. This thrombosis can lead to clotting of blood vessels and thus to damage the brain, the kidney, liver, and the CNS by reduced circulation. In severe cases, patients can develop a septic shock when the inflammation gets out of control. We call this a cytokine storm with an enormous risk to die. And what are the symptoms of the disease? General symptoms in the beginning of the disease are flu-like symptoms with fever, headache, and muscle pain. Additionally, the people are complaining about the loss of taste and smell, stomach pain with digestion problems, and less appetite can occur. When the sickness gets more severe, you can have dry cough and dyspnea. These are symptoms of contribution of the lung with pneumonia, and in later state, the lung tissue can even be destroyed. Other symptoms of heart contribution are developing a cardiomyopathy with loss of fitness. Then there is a high risk of getting a heart attack. And as I said before, all symptoms of thrombosis or embolism are possible. So what do I see in the hospital I work in? I see a high variety of symptoms and severance. We have a definition of three stages of severeness. At first, mild cases, they can be cured at home. They are comparable to a strong flu. People with a medium stadium, with medium strong symptoms, these patients are hospitalized and often already oxygen or medical treatment is needed. And the people with the heavy symptoms, the third stadium, these patients are at the IMC or ICU in the hospital. In these cases, respiratory support with a mask or tube ventilation is indicated, mostly because of the IRDS, the lung failure. It should be mentioned that about 10 to 20% of the hospitalized patients need an IMC or ICU. And sadly, up to 40% of these COVID patients on the ICU, they die. And this is the reality I see in my hospital. Next question is, what are the risk factors for developing a COVID disease? At first, a higher age, or and pre-existing illnesses like coronary sickness or other heart failures. Diabetes and obesity are also risk factors, and long-time smoking. This is a risk factor for developing a COVID disease. But how you get infected? The spreading of the COVID happens by incorporating infectious drops, mostly by aerosols in the air getting in contact with mucosa. Aerosols are droplets that float in the air. They can exist for a longer time, depending on the situation, even longer than 30 minutes. And in these droplets, the virus stays active. The big problem with this new disease is a prolonged incubation time of 5 to 7 days. And during this time, the virus can be spread. That means the infected person can spread the virus without knowing that he or she is infected. And with this, the virus reaches a lot of people. So, how can I prevent getting infected? First of all, protect myself from aerosols and droplets. And how do I do this? Keep your distance, follow hygienic rules, and wear a protection mask. Even easy ones help already a lot. So, here you can see a FFP2 mask. This is very tight, seals well, and is used in hospitals. And here, this one, this is a simple cotton mask. Easy to breathe and still pretty effective in retaining droplets and aerosols. But how does COVID affect us as divers? At first, the lung. The lung tissue gets remodeled, and this leads to altered diffusion and a reduced gas exchange in the lung. This can be critical for CO2 retention and decompression behavior. Also, air trapping is possible, and the risk for barotrauma and pneumothorax is rising after pneumonia. For the heart, a residual heart failure reduces the fitness and increases the risk for heart attack. For the CNS, it is reported that the cognitive deficiency can last for a long time, like months. Thrombosis, embolism, because of the diver's diuresis, the risk for thrombosis and embolism is already higher. The additional effect from COVID infection increases the risk further. What do I suggest to divers asking for medical advice after an infection? So in this situation, this is individual and depending on the symptoms. Generally speaking, for Germany and Europe, the medical clearance for diving becomes invalid after COVID infection. And in general, a detailed physical exploration with additional tests like spirometry, ECG is needed. There are international recommendations for returning after a COVID infection to diving. They are depending on the severity of the illness. So if you had mild symptoms, when the symptoms are gone, just 1 month no diving, and then you can ask for a medical examination and clearance. If you had middle strong symptoms, when the symptoms are gone, 3 months no diving, and then you can go to the doctor, ask for a medical examination and clearance. And if you were suffering from a severe sickness, when the symptoms are gone, after 3 to 6 months no diving, then medical examination and clearance is possible to ask for, and in this case, additional tests are needed. So, what can I say for mild symptoms, which are the most common? For mild symptoms and just 1 week recovery, the risk for permanent damage to the lung, to the heart, or to the brain is very low. But after all, there are discussions going on if COVID is an absolute contraindication for diving. But this is not clear yet. So please, don't go just diving after COVID infection. First, see your doctor. So to sum all this up, COVID can be a really dangerous illness that affects us as divers heavily. So please follow the rules to prevent an infection, distance, hygienic rules, wear a mask. Take care of your general health, and once you got infected, see a doctor before you return to diving. We are all still learning what this disease means for divers, and more evidence is needed. For this, Dan set up a study with divers who had a COVID infection, where you can participate. For more information about the Dan study, please find the link in the comments under this video. So, that's it from my side. I hope you found this video helpful. Please take care, stay healthy. Hope to meet you all again somewhere in the world diving when the situation is back to normal. Goodbye and see you soon.